Okay, good afternoon. In today's lesson, we are going to look at criteria of purity. Criteria of purity. Okay, this is a chemistry lesson where we look at how pure substances are. Now, under this same topic, we are going to discover how you can know a pure substance. Okay, apart from that, you are also going to look at the importance of purity of substances. That's what we are going to look at now. The word criteria of purity, what does it mean? Okay, what does the word criteria of purity mean? Okay, it means that in simpler terms, we can say this refers to all those physical properties which are characteristics of pure substances. All those physical properties which are characteristics of what of pure substances. Okay, that's the whole instance of that criteria of purity. Okay, now, how can you test a substance for purity? Okay, there are some ways on how you can test a substance for purity. You can test a substance for purity by determining certain factors. Okay, certain properties. Some of these properties include the boiling point. Okay, the boiling point of a substance. Okay, at what point does it boil? Okay, boiling point, by definition, this is the temperature at which a substance boils, or the temperature at which a liquid changes to a gas. Okay, so the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. That's the boiling point of water, 100 degrees Celsius. That's when it will change to vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. Then freezing point. Okay, freezing point, by definition, this is the temperature. As long as there is a word point, it means a temperature. Okay, freezing point is a temperature at which a substance changes from liquid to a solid. Okay, the freezing point of water ranges from 4 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. These are the ranges of what? The freezing point of what? Water. Okay? Melting point. Melting point is a temperature at which a substance changes from solid to liquid. Okay? Changes from solid to liquid. That's the melting point. Okay? Melting point of water is 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's the melting point of water. Okay, the other way you can test a substance, you can test a substance for purity by determining its density. How denser? Okay, how does it? What is its density in short? Okay, all these, they will help us, all these four factors or these physical properties, they will help us to determine a substance for purity. Okay? Now, all those substances that are not pure, they have variation in their physical properties. They do not have fixed physical properties. For example, if they are melting, you discover that their melting point varies. Okay, it won't have a specific melting point, meaning that substance is not what? Pure. It boils at different temperatures. That substance is not pure. Okay? Thus, that's how impure substances behave. Now, if something is pure, there must be the reason why it's pure, and maybe the essence of purity. Okay, so we are going to look at the importance of purity of substances. Okay, if something is impure, automatically it will harm your health. Okay, if something is impure, automatically it's going to harm your health. Okay, one of the good reasons why purity is important, purity of substances like food stuffs, okay, food stuffs, drugs, water, these, they help us to do what? To have a good living. For example, if there is any small amount of impurities in food, drugs, and water, you discover that it will bring a lot of what? Illnesses, such as what? Diseases, okay? Illnesses, and at times people can even die because of what? Small amount of impure substances in those important stuffs. Okay, then the other one is those companies that produce, okay, those companies that produce drugs, those companies that process some drinks, some foods, they all make sure that whatever they process is checked for purity, how pure it is. Okay, they check regularly to ensure that their product is what? Pure. Okay, so all these are some of the importance of what? Purity. Okay, this is the lesson I had for you. Good afternoon.